Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.7 Beta 1. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers, although Apple released this fairly late in the day, so it may be available the following day. I'll let you know in the comments below. Now, as far as the overall size, this varied greatly depending on the version you're coming from. It was 349.3 megabytes. That was on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and it really depends if you're coming from iOS 14.5, 14.5.1, or 14.6 release candidate, for example. It could be much larger, and it was up to 4.58 gigabytes on my different devices. So I have it installed on the iPhone XR as well as the iPhone 6S Plus. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 14.7 Beta 1 that I have on the iPad Air 2, WatchOS 7.6, which I'll probably install on this Apple Watch, as well as macOS Big Sur 11.5 Beta 1, and tvOS 14.7 Beta 1. Also, there's an update if you're using HomePods to HomePodOS 14.7 Beta 1. So all of those are available for developers now and hopefully soon to public beta testers, if it's not out by the time of this video. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and you can see the build number is 18G5023C. And this particular build was a bit of a surprise since iOS 14.7 is not out at this time. I'll talk about when to expect that a little bit later. But the first new thing is there is a modem update in this particular update with the iPhone 12 Pro Max anyway. So there's a modem update, but the modem update's actually a version older than we have on iOS 14.6, for example, with the release candidate. So it looks like Apple may have split the two developments of 14.6 and 14.7. And so we're a little bit behind on the 14.7 release with the modem firmware. I think that's the first time we've seen that. Now, something else that's new that you may have already seen is if you're on iOS 14.6 and you have the beta profile and you go to software update, down at the bottom, it says also available 14.7. So if you're not seeing it, that may be why it's down at the bottom. They changed this. So 14.7, and you'll see it's 4.57 gigabytes. That's on a 12 Pro Max as well. So you can go back to software update and choose not to install it if you don't want to either, but it's there at the bottom. We've sort of seen that in the past as well, but that's something that's new since they've been pushing with 14.6 and 14.7. Now, another small change I've found is if we go under Settings and then we go to Wi-Fi, under Wi-Fi, where it says Networks, it now says Other Networks. Prior to this, it just said Networks. So it's a little bit different. Let me show you that. Now, on the left is iOS 14.6. On the right is 14.7 Beta 1. And it says Other Networks at the top right there. So that's something they've changed. It's a very small change, but it is something a little bit different. Now, if you actually have AirTags and you were actually managing devices and had people adding AirTags to their managed devices, there's now options to disable that. So what that would mean is you can disable an AirTag from being added to, say, an iPad or an iPhone or an iPod Touch if you're a manager of a device. And if they try to add it, it will pop up a message saying that your device management settings do not support AirTag pairing on this iPhone. For assistance, contact your system administrator. So that's something they've added with 14.7. Now, Apple also previewed some new features today, and you'll see it says Apple previews powerful software updates designed for people with disabilities. And starting tomorrow on May 20th, they'll have a new sign time service that helps those that need to use sign language to communicate. So you'll have this option for visiting the Apple store and maybe with remote access as well. So this will be available starting tomorrow. And then they previewed additional features that are coming in the future for different accessibility features, such as assistive touch on the Apple Watch with updates, as well as eye tracking support for iPad with a third-party accessory, and explore images with VoiceOver. So it will tell you that there's a person there, explain where their head position is as well, and it understands more about the image overall. So I can't wait to try that out. That should be in a future release. Also, made for iPhone hearing aids and audiogram support, so you'll have information about that. And this may be a hint at iOS 15 in its design, where it's not edge to edge anymore. You'll see they're in boxes. They'll also have new background sounds to help you. Maybe you're working and you want to get things done, but you don't want music. You just want some white noise in the background. You'll have that option as well. So you'll have some balance noise, the ocean sound, rain, stream, and maybe that will help you sleep as well. So all of those should be coming in the future, and you can see how the options are no longer edge to edge, but rather encapsulated in a box, similar to what we had with iOS 14 or iOS 6 rather. So now we're on iOS 14. They may be going back a little bit, and maybe it's a small preview of iOS 15. And then there's more Animoji, for example, for those with disabilities, or maybe someone with oxygen or a nasal cannula, as well as a different helmet here, or a soft helmet, and cochlear implant as well. So there's a lot of different changes. Also, there's information about Apple Fitness Plus and Apple's commitment to making Fitness Plus as accessible and inclusive as possible. So all of this was launched today, as well as shortcuts for accessibility gallery and more. So there's a lot of new accessibility features coming that I can't wait to see. I think this is great. They started with iOS 14.6, where you can reboot your phone and use your voice to unlock it. Now, that was something that wasn't there before. That was added with 14.6, and we're going to see more accessibility features in the future, whether it be with iOS 14.7 or maybe iOS 15 a little bit later. Now, on iPadOS 14.7 Beta 1, we get the exact same changes I already mentioned. However, Apple updated the Apple Store app today with significant changes for iPad to make it more consistent across different apps. So if you're on an iPhone or an iPad and you open the Apple Store for the first time, you'll actually get a pop-up or a new splash screen that says new sidebar designed for iPad. Also, get all the essentials. Now you can seamlessly add a keyboard or Apple Pencil when shopping for your iPad, and then new virtual sessions. So this is new when you open the Apple Store for the first time if you're using that app. And so if we go into the Apple Store on the iPad, you'll see that we have a sidebar now. So on the side is a sidebar. You've got sessions and for you. And if we rotate to portrait, it moves to the side. We can go back, and now we have the sidebar, just like we did before with all of the different apps, such as music, for example. So you'll see this open up here, music for the first time. We'll wait for it to open, and we have the sidebar. And that leads me to overall performance. Something I've noticed significantly on this is how fast it is. It's actually quite fast on older devices. So the iPad Air 2, you saw how it was responding there. If we go to the iPhone 6S Plus, for example, I thought it seemed quite a bit faster the first time I opened it. You'll see it's much smoother. If you saw any of the 14.6 videos, it did hiccup there a little bit. But in general, it feels much faster, especially on the new devices. So the older devices are a little bit slower today, but if you're going into iPhone XR, or when I was looking for what was new with the iPhone 12 Pro Max, for example, it feels much faster for some reason to me. I'm not sure if it's a change in animation speed, smoothness, but it just seems to be a little bit different. So the XR is keeping up quite nicely as far as scrolling speeds or going into apps, for example. So it does seem pretty good there. Now, as far as overall battery life, it will take a few days to know what that's like for sure. However, I can show you the battery life on 14.6, and hopefully it will improve with 14.7. So on my iPhone 12 Pro Max here, running 14.6 that I've been using full time, you'll see yesterday I had 3 hours and 42 minutes of screen on time, 37 minutes of screen off time, and used a little bit over 50% of my battery life. I'm finding that I get about 8 to 10 hours of screen on time with 14.6 release candidate, for example. On 14.7, it's possible it can improve. And one thing I noticed is the phone wasn't that warm when it rebooted. Generally, when a phone reboots, it's quite warm. It's processing a lot in the background. It actually felt quite cool to the touch. So that was a little bit different. And that's true on all of these for some reason. I don't think I've ever seen that before where it doesn't get really hot. Normally it will warm up quite a bit. It was just a little bit warm from processing the update. I don't think I've seen that before in quite some time. So it seems to be promising there. Now, as far as the overall benchmarks, we'll take a look at those. We'll go over to Geekbench. I did run this a couple times and it's actually quite good. I scored 1600 for single core and 4142 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, like I said, I did run it a couple times, as you can see here. So it scored a little bit higher the first time on single core, the same on multi-core. So it's a little bit higher on single core than the previous run on April 30th, and multi-core is a little bit lower. And this just rebooted and then I ran it twice. So it could improve quite a bit. But like I said, it does feel significantly faster when scrolling and just moving through it overall so far. Now let's take a look at all these devices. Now from left to right, I have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 10. XR, and then the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And again, this is just to give you a general idea from some of the oldest devices up to the latest device. If you have anything close to this, you should be good to go. And it just gives you a general idea of overall benchmarks. That leads me to, should you install iOS 14.7 beta 1? And I would say if you're a developer and you're testing an app and you want to make sure it's compatible, or you have an extra device and maybe you want to manage devices and see how that AirTag device management part works, well, then definitely try it out. However, if you're on the public version and it's on your main device, there isn't really any significant features yet that would be worth trying out, unless they're one of the ones I already mentioned. So I would hold off as far as that goes. Otherwise, it seems pretty stable, but it's only been an hour or two at this point. So it will take a few days to know what that's like. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 14.6, since it's not out yet, I would say based off that accessibility page, maybe as soon as tomorrow, since they're going to release this new sign time feature tomorrow. That makes me think that they'll push this out very quickly instead of waiting until next week. So it makes a lot of sense that they might push it out as soon as tomorrow to the public, and then we'll be on the iOS 14.7 betas, along with iOS 15 when we see it on June 7th at WWDC. So we'll see iOS 15 beta 1 on June 7th if Apple continues to do what they've done in the past. And then we'll have iOS 14 betas all the way up until September, where they normally release iOS 15 if they keep things the same as they always have. So based off that, that's what I would expect. Of course, that could always change, but at this point, that seems likely. So 14.6 maybe tomorrow, 14.7 possibly in June, at some point, maybe later in June, maybe even July, depending on how many betas they have and what features they roll out to it. But if you've found anything else, though, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.